You know, and we were both fans of Parkinson, you know, one of the greatest chat shows this country's ever had. You ever watch an episode of that where Parky be sort of filling for 5 minutes?
7:40. My schedule says 7:45.
I'm sorry, that's just the one that was just penciled in the middle
of that record.
7:35. First part of the interview with David Tennant.
In the middle of that underplayed record that you just had on that I've never heard on the radio before. That's when I arrived.
Well, you're finally here. Good morning, David
Tennant. Good morning. It's lovely to be here.
And David has come this morning dressed as a pen pal from France.
It's quite something, isn't it?
Here he is. Good morning, Jean-Claude. Who meets La Rochelle.
Bonjour.
Wow, it's a very colourful outfit today.
Do you like these? These are my new favourite trousers.
Now, what colour is that? Would you call that a butterscotch?
I wouldn't have called it a butterscotch, but now you've called it a butterscotch.
Is that a butterscotch?
I wouldn't have called it a butterscotch, but now you've called it a butterscotch. I'm quite persuaded by that description.
What would you call that, Rich?
I think the actual hue for pants. Artists is burnt okra, I think you'll find.
Isn't it burnt? Like, wouldn't that be darker, a burnt okra?
Max, you're a lady. What colour is that?
I'm sorry about this, David, but I'm going to say a salmon pink.
That is not a pink.
I tell you what it's looked like. It's looked like salmon pink has been washed with a butterscotch jumper or maybe a nice blouse of your missus, and that's the colour that's been left.
Well, I'm quite happy with them.
It's not. They're very nice.
They are lovely.
Always
David
fashionable.
Them.
Thanks, no, it's, Maggie. They look great. But with a blue T-shirt with
stripes, yellow stripes, yeah.
A blue blazer.
Yeah, yeah.
Are you here for the Olympics? You look very, very dapper.
Yeah, you're very kind.
You look very, very nice. So listen, tell us about the movie. I've been reading up on it. It is a who-who's of British talent. You've got Hugh Grant is in this as the pirate captain.
Yeah.
So it's an Aardman thing.
It's an Aardman thing. Yeah. You know, Chicken Run, Wallace and Gromit. Yeah. And this is their latest offering. So it's all the stop motion little puppets. It's brilliant.
So, and you obviously would have got involved on the stop motion stuff as well. You would have been there with Nick Park sort of going, David,
sleeves,
can you move up the left arm, please?
Yeah. The last thing, I feel slightly embarrassed being hauled out to promote this because, I mean, I did, you know, 5 sessions in a voiceover studio, and really the real genius is these people who take 3 years of their life.
Yeah, but people aren't interested in that, are they? So what, you weren't there, because otherwise it would be the hardest thing to ever make. You weren't there real time when he's there moving the arm up. David,
yeah,
can you
one
just
syllable
saying,
at the time.
Ah.
Yeah.
So is that how it worked then? He would do all his bits and you just had the voice.
Yeah, we did like a couple of like rehearsal runs where we recorded the script and they took that away and used that to start the animation, I suppose. Yeah. And then we would come back every so often over it. I mean, it took over 2 years, I think.
And it's Morph in this one.
Morph isn't featured in this, no.
Okay.
But it's directed by Peter Lord, who is the man who brought you Morph.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
And so what's the idea? Is it something to do with the Pirate King Awards?
Yeah, the Pirate King. Pirate Captain is not a particularly successful pirate, and his dream is to win Pirate of the Year.
Yeah.
So him and his crew of misfits kind of go plundering.
It's a great idea for a kids' movie. Yeah. My kids, I love this.
Yeah.
You know, and Easter's coming up.
Exactly, yeah. And they don't manage to... initially, they're having trouble getting the right booty. And then they come across Charles Darwin's
when you don't mean booty, you mean bounty. Be careful, because I know you're going on Radio 1. You're trying to obviously drop some of the language you might do over there. Booty. Booty is what they say for... No, they say that for backside, for ladies.
That's the new definition. But booty
you're
also
old
means...
school.
You know, yeah, exactly. I'm old school. I'm pirates.
You mean bounty?
Pirates were always after a bounty.
They were never after booty unless you're talking about... Nick Arman has now made an X-rated claimation.
Yeah, I'm not too sure about the booty term.
No.
I think women might find it offensive.
Yeah. This is your date. This is your booty gate.
Sunday. Yeah.
Can you call the sun on Sunday?
What have I stepped into?
Burnt orange by the look of those pants.
Yep, there you go.
And you are the young Charlie Darwin.
I'm Charles Darwin, yeah.
So the accent isn't...
It's not Paisley in this one, no.
What is it then?
It's a little more,
Hello, yes,
exactly, that's it. That's
really?
Pretty much exactly it.
I could have undercut you by a couple of hundred quid. You could,
I was really expensive.
Charlie.
Yeah. You could have done that.
Can we have a little bit of the young Charlie D?
What, a Darwin off?
Yeah, yeah. Let's hear your one.
I think that you'll find that's a baboon's kidney. It's all a bit like that.
You know who's channeled there?
Go on.
Oh, Betty.
Yeah, Michael Crawford.
It's Michael Crawford. Frank. What is going on with you, by the way? Are you finding that off-putting?
It looks a little bit like he's a burns victim now. You've plastered this stuff all over his face.
If you've just joined the show, I have a facial twitch this morning.
Yeah.
My upper lip is out of control, as is my right eyelid, and we've had to put surgical tape over my face to keep it under control.
I haven't seen any twitching. Now, either the tape's working very
the
well.
The tape is working.
Right.
Yeah.
Take the tape off, and then you can show David.
Oh, that's going to hurt. That's going to smart.
Oy! That's his upper lip, and the eyebrow one as well. There we go, crikey. Now, right, let's just see if it's... Maybe it's cured it and reset your face. Like
I
a controlled alt-delete for the visage.
I'm not seeing anything. It looks pretty good.
You must have seen that. He just did it. See?
What, that? I thought that was a joke.
No, he can't help himself.
No, I can't help it.
No.
It's quite sexy, though. It's like a little pouch.
Yeah, but I'm not wanting to do that to you.
I tell you what it looks like. You're on the lookout for some pirate booty. I tell you what, you know you've got Siri.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you ask Siri, what does booty mean, Rich? Okay. Okay. All right, let's find out what Siri says about this. We'll come back after this song, find out what actually booty does mean and what DT has ever got himself into now. It's Green Day on Absolute Radio, 7:53. Our guest this morning is David Tennant. Green Day, time of your life on Absolute Radio. It is 5 to 8. Our very special guest this morning, so nice to have him back on the show, is DT.
Oh, yeah.
David Tennant. And his new movie is out next Wednesday. It's called The Pirates in an Adventure with Scientists. Okay, so David was taking us through the movie about the Pirate of the Year awards.
Yeah.
Okay, and you've used the phrase booty.
Yeah.
Now, this maybe is a Scottish colloquialism, but to me, booty, I don't know where this has been reappropriated by the kids, booty means loving. People go,
it means treasure. It means treasure.
Well,
bounty.
One man's treasure. Maybe in showbiz, treasure is ladies and hot loving.
Yeah.
I'm sure it started as bounty, but, you know, if you're a pirate, you're on the high seas, bounty quite quickly morphs to bounty, booty. Bounty. You can hear it happening.
The late Bernard Matthews is in this movie. To me, if you're saying that he's going looking for booty, it means he's looking for ladies.
Yes.
Okay, it's sort of a rap term, isn't it?
Yeah.
Me and I look for the booty.
You make a booty call.
Yeah. That's it, a booty call.
Indeed.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
I think it has a dual meaning.
Okay, well, let's ask Siri if there is a dual meaning.
Okay.
Or even a dual meaning.
What does the word booty mean?
Yes.
To just blow in Siri's little...
A shop that sells women's clothes and jewellery.
A shop?
It thinks I've said boutique.
You go into Wikipedia. We're soon far. We'll put this to bed.
Yeah.
Okay,
just
work this out once
a while. Get a dictionary up.
So after 8 o'clock, we're going to be doing Snack Genius. This is where once a week on the show, we test out your various recipes. Richie eats them and works out whether they're snack hell or snack genius.
Mm.
We tried to do this last time you were on.
Yeah.
Failed because we couldn't find the right ingredients.
Yeah.
What is your snack genius that after 8 we're going to be trying out?
We have some very cheap, spongy, thick... cut white bread.
Oh, look at that. It's old school.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's brilliant.
We have some crunchy original peanut butter.
Great.
We have some cheap and nasty sunflower spread.
Oh, my word. You have literally put no money into this feature.
And we have a Matheson's U-shaped smoked pork sausage. Wait till I weave my magic with these ingredients.
What's up?
Booty. Plunder taken from an enemy.
Ooh,
good,
yeah!
Goods or property seized by piracy.
Thanks.
Or a valuable prize.
Yeah, yeah.
Maggie owes David Tennant an apology for saying that women would find that offensive about basically jewellery.
Thank you.
David,
yes?
I would like to forcefully apologise to you.
Forcefully?
Thank you,
she's going to forcefully apologise to
As
you.
As in, I am being forced to apologise
sure.
to you.
Sure.
I'd like to take it back, and I hope this hasn't affected our relationship.
Oh, Maggie,
anyway.
No, I'm fine with you. It's
good.
These guys here that
thank
I
you,
feel
David.
Abused
you
by.
See through
Listen,
them as well.
I was only trying to protect you from an incident, that's all. News of what is coming up next. Feels like we're at a like a wedding or a wedding reception or something with this on. This is Gino, Dexy's Midnight Runners on Absolute Radio. It's 8:10. David Tennant is our special guest this morning. You can hear his beautiful voice in a movie which comes out next Wednesday. The Pirates in an Adventure with Scientists is out a week today on March the 28th. Annoyingly, I have to be honest and say this, you look very fresh-faced for someone who is a double dad.
A double? You're right, yeah. Baby's nearly a year, and I adopted my wife's boy last year as well, so I became a father twice within 6 months. That's a bit something of a record, I think, isn't
it? I think, I'm not sure if you need to contact the Guinness Book of Records for that, but that is amazing, because Ty, Ty normally listens when you come on. Is he still listening to
the
show?
I hope so. I hope he's listening, yeah.
The highlight of your fantastic wedding reception was seeing Ty go up to Darren Brown and say, show us a trick. Yeah. And now, obviously, Darren is he's an amazing showman.
Yeah.
On him, he had very little other than a coin, and he did the trick that I do with my kids and your grandparents used to do, and actually shamelessly went, oh, what's that behind your ear? Pulled out a 50 pence piece.
Nice.
It's the lowest rent trick you'll ever see Darren Brown do. But that's fantastic news. Right, let's do this now.
Want to see more? We keep the best bits for our closest friends. To watch the rest of this interview...